Hi all, welcome to the channel, welcome to the world, this is the World of Wayne. We have now got pack 3 of the Agora models released to build the New York fire truck. Now the reputation of this box precedes itself. We're actually going to sort of be completing the cab, and we do have the metal surround for the cab section as well. Its reputation does precede it though, because I've heard it's quite a difficult pack. So I've got no idea, haven't even looked at it. So the first time I'm looking at it is while I'm doing this build here. I'll have it no other way. If you want to get this for yourself, once again, I'll put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get that all the way from pack 1. And over there, you'll also find the Titanic pre-sale, which is coming out in May. And you've also got the Porsche 917KH pre-sale. That's over there as well. And then coming soon as well, we've also got the Lamborghini Miura. And there's more details coming with that the weekend from Agora Models. And that will be on their website. Anyway, without further ado, let's get cracking. So this is all going to start with stage 17. We're doing the jump seat and the front right light cluster. Now, I do believe we're going to have a lot of stuff to do regarding electrics in this stage. But it all starts with the jump seat, which looks like this. And all of these parts are in their individual bags to protect them. So the first thing we're going to be doing is taking the jump seat and the base of that. We're going to be pushing that onto this section here. No glue, it's just a real strong push down. You heard that click there to lock that into place. Now bringing over the cab section that we've done previously, this is going to be going onto this side here. So it's going to be sitting on just like this. It's going to be held in with a tight H screw. Got that here. I've got a new screwdriver I'm experimenting with. This is an electronic screwdriver. This was sent to me by Troy Monroe. So I really appreciate that, Troy. I'm going to see how this works out. We're then going to want to put the flashlight in. This is what the flashlight looks like. It's got a D-shaped lug on that. That's just going to go in front of the computer there. So it has got a direction which this goes. Now there's a lot of paint on this. So if you have trouble getting this in, and it might be worth just taking the paint off that. I'm going to test fit it first. Yeah, I am going to give it a quick sand just to remove some of that paint. And then that will enable it to slip in much easier. And when that's in, that should look just like that. So I will put the screen back in now. I've taken it off just to protect it while I was not building anything onto this stage. I just want to make sure that's sitting perfectly in there, which it is. So the screen's in. We're going to be putting the walkie-talkie in, or the portable radio. Very detailed. Look, check that out. That looks just like that. That's just going to go into the D-shaped hole that we can just see there. And again, it's just a push-in. Perfect. We've then got the battery charger. That looks just like this. Now we're turning our attention to the back of this cab now. That's going to go on this side here. Again, it's got a D-shaped hole. So that will dictate which way around it goes. So it goes this way here, like that. And then once that's in, we can keep that nice and safe to one side, because we're going to be creating the front right light cluster. So this is the reflector, and this is what that looks like on both sides. We've got a lens to put in. Now the lens does come in its own pack here, so let's get that out. Actually, in here I've got three lenses. Now these lenses are going to diffuse the lights that are coming through here, and it's the bigger one that I actually want. So I'm going to push that in. It is quite a tight fit, but it should fit lovely in there, just like that. Now we've got a turn lens, single turn lens, indicator lens if you like. That looks like this with an arrow on it. Turn this over, and that's going to go on top of the section. As you can see, we've got the dome side of the lens there. We want the arrow pointing towards the left. And again, that's a push in, so that looks just like that. The two other lenses we've got here, in a similar fashion to what we just done, are going to go into the bottom holes here. They are a very snug fit in here, so they do require a little bit of pushing to get them to lie flat. But they're in. So that looks like that from that side. And then we've got a front light cluster lens to go off the top. There's two of these. and they're just going to be going into this section here. Now that will diffuse the lights there. So one there and just one in the other side. Now they do fit quite snug. They're not going to fall out. So that's that light cluster completed. The fun starts now because we've got the circuit board to put behind that. This is the circuit board here with the LEDs on. Just going to get these wires off this strip. I always stretch these wires out just to stop any tangles. I find it easy to manage them as well. Turning this upside down again, this is actually going to go in the three prongs that we can see there. So it's going to sit in just like this. So that the LEDs on this side are going to light the lenses below it. Now that's going to be held in with a Type M screw, which I've got here. And for some parts of this build, I am going to use my new electric screwdriver I've got now. And when that board's on, it should look just like that. Now I believe we don't get to try the lights out in this stage, so we're just going to have to bear in mind that that might be working, might not, but when we test it, we know how to fix this. But that's all there is to do in that stage. We have got a couple of items left over. We've got this one left over, and it looks like we've got one windscreen wiper as well. So moving on to stage 18, we've got the front left cab door, and we've got a crew seat as well. So just like we did previously, I'll take the crew seat out here. And once again, we're going to be putting the base onto this section here, making sure that the large shaft is pointed towards the back of the chair. Bring over the cab again. This one's going to go right down the very back here. So I'm going to put that into place, just like that. And that's going to be held in from the other side with a Type H screw. So I've got that from the underside. That's just going to go into this hole here. And I will use my heavy duty screwdriver just to lock that in nice and tight. Once again, put that to one side because we're going to be working on the left cab door. I do love how all of these stuff is individually bagged. These bags are invaluable for storing things in. I've got some cogs in here as well and a handle. In fact, it's the handle that we're going to need first. That's going to go into the hole here. Just like we've done from the previous doors. Make sure that's pushed flush. But we want that all the way through there. So I think what I'm going to do, because I don't want to break it, is I'm going to put a little bit of oil just on the end to help slip that in. So it goes in all the way. We go. That's able to operate there, as you can see, but you can see that on the other side. So on the other side, we're going to be pushing this gear into place. Again, it's shaped, so we just want to match up the shape. And there we go, that's pushed onto there. So when I turn the handle, as you can see, the gear moves, no problems at all. Now we're going to want to put some super glue just into these four points here. Put a little drop in, 2, 3, and this tiny one at the top there, 4, because we're going to merge this onto the cab door, which I'll get out here, and this is going to enable us to operate the window. So when we're happy with how we got this, let's get that out of the place, put that on, and push that down, and just ensure that that's engaged so I can operate the window, as you can see there. Excellent. That went easier than I thought it would. So if we just turn this over, we're going to be putting the inner cab panel onto the metal section that we can just see there. And basically this is just going to be going, I'll do a dry fit just to show you how this goes. It's going to be going on just like that. Now I need to glue this into place, so I am going to put some glue just around those points there. Not so much on the lugs, but next to them, because that's the part that's going to be in contact with the metal. And compared to other builds, you will notice I'm being a lot more generous with the glue than I normally do. It's because these parts are going to have to take quite a lot of weight. So I want to make sure there's plenty of solvent glue on there to hold that into place. So that's in place. And then this is where I will put a little tiny bit of glue. Just in this section of the door here on either side. And in the lug there. Because I have got the handle to put in. It's a D-shaped connection, so it can only go in one way. Hold that into place. And there we go. That's the door completed, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Absolutely loads to do in stage 19. We're doing components for the dashboard and the roof. It looks like we've got a lot of electrics here. So the first thing we're going to do is put the dashboard kick plate into its position here. Now that's just going to go, see these two holes at the bottom here, these two lugs, we're just going to push them onto the two lugs that we've got here. So this, pushing it up, is going to go onto these. Now I don't know if we need to glue them. I don't think we do, because I think they are going to be quite a tight fit. I will check that. It does just clip in. You probably heard that there. So that looks just like that. Now, while we've got this upside down, you'll see that on this side here, we've got some holes at the top. We need to insert these buttons in to those holes. So we're going to need some tweezers for this and just put these in. It wouldn't make a difference whether this was attached or not, because they are going to be a little bit tricky to put in. So we've got two to put in here. Now, these will eventually operate the siren. We don't glue these or anything because we need them to be loose in there so we can push them, so when they're in they look just like that. So that means we've got to put the PCB board with the switches, as you can hear it's here, they can click behind it. This is the one that we want. This is going to slot into the channel just behind those switches we just installed. You want to make sure it's quite deep in there, so it would actually hold its own weight. But more interested is, if I hold it, can I push these buttons? Yes and yes. Now, we've got another PCB board to put in. There's actually two attached to this cable here. I'm interested in this one here, which is going to operate the horn. I'm going to split that wire a little bit because I want to put this into that hole next to there so it comes out the other side. So that looks like that there. Because we're going to be assembling the steering column now. So gently, I'm going to put that to one side. And we'll get the steering column in place, which means I need to take the main part of the column out. Lots of empty bags. That looks like that. And we're going to be aligning the turn signal button into this section here, which is quite simply, we're just going to be putting it into the top like this and then pushing that into place. Again, it holds itself in, but that's what that looks like. Now they do want us to add a tiny bit of glue just to the tabs there, because we don't want this falling out. So just a tiny bit of glue each side there to the tabs, and then I'll re-put that in, and there we go, that's there for all time. Now bringing back over the dashboard, the control board that we just put in, we are going to be now putting the switch part of this, that's the switch side, this one, behind that horn button, which means we can slot this in all the way. So now when I press this, as you can hear, you might be able to hear a click. That's operating that switch, no problems at all. Now I want to close off the other side to stop that board falling out with this tab here. So turn it upside down and put this into place. It will pinch the wires. Now they've got the wires coming just out the side of this. Now I am going to just put some glue around this edge here, because I'm aware that one edge is not really going to be able to seat very well, because obviously that's where the wires are coming out. Now there is sort of like a channel for this wire to go down on the other side. So I'm just going to line that up, get it in that channel. That will enable me to put that top section in like that. It is still up at one side. I'm just seeing if I can make any improvements on that. Don't think I'm going to be able to, but I'm pretty happy with how that is. That's going to lock that into place. Just check that horn still works. No problems at all. So we're going to be putting the steering column into place, and it's just going to go into the slot here, very close to the top. It sort of clips itself in, actually. So now that's locked in just like that. You probably would have noticed that my switches have fallen out, so I'm going to have to put them back in. But that's not a problem at all. That's back in there. So when we're done, as you can see, switches in behind, steering column in place there. So to hold that steering column in place, I'm going to screw that in from behind with this type E screw here. Just started that off. Let's make that nice and tight. Now, right at the very top here, you'll notice there's another hole, which we're going to be dropping another switch in, or another switch cover. Again, I'm using my tweezers here. And I'll drop that in. And I want to put a little bit of glue just in the channel next to it here. Just in there. And another one just on this side here. Because we're going to be putting this circuit board in now, which will go in this way. Push that all the way in. So that fits flush in there. So check this switch and make sure that switches as well, which it does. That's perfect. Now we're going to be putting the map light in. This has got a D-shaped opening here. That's just going to go into this point just here. So that looks like that. We've got a GPS display. That's going to go into the two holes at the top there. And these two holes are slightly different sizes, so it'll dictate what way around they go. So that goes in there. That's a little bit loose, so I am going to put a little bit of glue in there just to keep that into place. If I do think anything's a little bit loose, I have been gluing it, just so you know. So, I mean, that's quite tight, but that one is a little bit loose there. We've got a storage box to put in. Just get that out. That's just going to go this way round on this side. Again, the lugs will tell you which way round it goes. That's quite a tight fit on mine, so I don't need to glue that one. That's in there. And then we could just leave the dashboard for a second, put that to one side. And we're going to bring over, we haven't seen this one for a while, just the roof section here. And on the roof section, we've got a radio antenna to go on, which is going to match the one that we had on the other side there. Again, it has got different size lugs at the bottom to locate this. So they're just going to go in there and just push them in. Quite a firm push, this one, but they will go in. You probably heard that click then, but there we go. That's the other one in. So we've got two down there. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Once again, we've got a couple of parts left over. We've got this white section here, and we have got this kick plate here as well. Now in stage 20, we've got the jump seat, cab equipment, and front left light cluster. So once again, we're going to start this by creating the other seat. So we need the seat and we need the base. And in this pack, you'll notice we've got another windscreen wiper there. So once again, push that into place like that. How on earth did I realize that that first seat was in the wrong way? I'm gonna say it again because I like saying it. I make mistakes, so you don't have to. Obviously that seat needs to face the opposite direction, so just goes to show you can get it in. There you go. So that one's in. I'll tighten that up. The only reason I've noticed that is because obviously putting the other seat in, I've noticed the other one was around the wrong way. Stupid me. This is why you watch the channel. I don't claim to be perfect. So once that's in, I'm going to put that in with a type H screw. So I've got one of them here. Turn that over. And I'll get that in here. So we have now got the two seats in there, facing the right way, Wayne. I put that to one side because we're going to be assembling the water cooler now. I can't believe I did that. But obviously, I bet you're all shouting at the screen then. But, you know, I'm aware of these things. So we've got these two parts here, which we're just going to link together first. Like this. Very tight fit, so they'll go together no problems at all. Now this, bringing over the cab again, is just going to go into the back section, just here into that hexagonal opening. It's going to be quite a tight push in, but it will fit in just like that. We've got another portable radio charger to go in front of it. Again, this has got a D-shaped lug, so this is going to dictate which way around this goes. That's going to go in front of it. We've got a cab cylinder, which is going to go into the last hexagonal hole here. So push that in. These can be a little bit tough to get in, but there you go. You'll hear it click when it goes in. And then put that to one side, because we're going to make the next light cluster. If you remember how we did this last time, we had the reflector panel here. And then we've got to have all the three lenses. We should be able to whiz through this now. So we push the first large lens through the larger hole at the top. Excellent. And then on the other side of that, we're going to put the turn signal lens in. This time it goes the other way, so it's pointing towards your right. So that's in there. And then at the bottom, we're going to be putting the other two lenses in. One and two. And then on the other side, let's give that a good push in there. There you go. On the other side, we've got the lenses to put in again. And just like we did last time, we've got the circuit board to go behind it. Going to be held in with a type M screw, so I'm going to have that loaded up already. Line it up to the lug, so it's this way around, ensuring that you can get your screw in between the wires there. Going to be a bit tricky, but I think I've managed it. So we do once again have some parts left over from this. We've got this part here, and we've got what looks to be a mirror, but that is all there is to do in that stage. So a ginormous one for stage 21. Look, check this out. We have got the main cab. So let's get this out. This is majorly impressive. Check that out. That looks excellent. If you want to have an idea of size, once again, I'm on the main camera here. That's what that looks like. Pretty impressive, huh? We've got absolutely loads of details in this pack. So I'm going to get everything out and we'll take our time putting these all into position. So the first thing I need is the rear cab vent, which I've got here. And that looks just like this. It's got two lugs at the back. We're going to take the cab. And this is going to be going into this section on the cab just there. The lugs are different sizes. And this is just a push to fit. But I think I am going to reinforce mine with a little bit of glue just behind it. We now need one of the rear cab panels, which looks like that. Again, these have got different holes on the back there. And these are going to go down these points here. So I'm just going to line up the holes. Probably best on the top camera. The larger hole goes towards the top. Smaller hole towards the bottom and push that in. Just checking that. Again, I am going to put a little bit of glue on this, because mine is quite a loose fit there. But here's the first one. And just do exactly the same on the other side. And there we go. That's those two in position. In a similar fashion to what we've just done, we're going to be doing exactly the same thing just on the side panels here. These are going to go into these side panels here. And again, I'm just going to check the fit. I think these ones are actually going to go in a lot tighter. Mine have. I'm not going to need to glue them. So that's one side. And I'll do the other side as well. Push those lugs all the way in. So they look like that. That's excellent. Look at the detail on that. Now we want one of these folding steps. They look just like that here. We're going to mount one of these in place first. As you can see, we have got a D-shaped hole there. This is, again, is just going to be pushed to fit, and it's shaped to let you know where it's going. It's going to go in there. Again, that's very loose on mine, so I think I'm going to glue that into place. And in the interest of symmetry, going to do exactly the same thing on the other side. So when they're both in, they should look like that. Just put the cap to one side for a second, because we're going to be creating one of the emergency lights now. There's six of these to make, so I'm going to get all the lenses out. And then on these sprues here, we do have the reflectors in here. Don't need the sprues for a minute. I'm just interested in these reflectors. There we go. On these sprues, looks like we've got some bars, handlebars here. So put them to one side. And all we're going to do is push these onto the lenses. And we've got to repeat that 6 times. There we go, I've created 6 lights there. We're going to be attaching them to the cab. Now, it is worth noting, once again, we've got a small lug at the back and a large lug. So that's going to aid us in orientation for this. So bringing this over, the first one, probably best on the top camera here, is just going to go into the front here. Making sure we align it so that the lugs are in the right place and just push that into position. Do the same thing on the other side. We're being very methodical here. There we go, that's in position as well. So the front two are done. Now we've got 2 side reflectors to put in place. These are really tiny, so let's get these out. These are going to go onto the point just there. I don't know how they're going to fit, so I'll put one in. Just see if I'm going to need to glue this. I think I am going to put a bit of glue in that because that does fit very loose. There we go, that's the one in that side. And we just repeat that on the other side. I love it with the symmetry in this because it does give you a quick heads up to where everything goes. That's the second lens in there as well. Now we've got a bag with side markers in. They look like this. They're going to go onto the hole just here. I am now just dropping glue into it because I'm assuming that we are going to need it. So we've got one on that side there. Turn it over. And likewise, a bit of glue in there. I've got one to put in this side. Make sure that's straight. If I turn this over again, I've got some power plugs to put inside. They're going into this D-shaped hole here. They're a little silver thing. So I'll put one in and you get an idea of what that looks like there. We've also got one to put just above it. Put that to one side because I'm going to get my sprue cutters now and just cut off all of these handles, making sure that I do cut off the little stalks that they're on as well, because that's what's going to attach it to the engine. Now these are going to go into all the positions, probably best on the top camera that you can see here. So we've got one at the back here. They are symmetrical, so it doesn't matter what way around you put them in. So that's 2 on that side. Let's do 2 on this side. And that's the 2 on that side. So they're both done now. We've just got 2 to put onto the backs. So again, look at the top camera. One in here. And one just on the other side here. So that looks like that. Perfect. And now we've got windows to put in. So I'll get the first window out. It looks like that. We want it this way around with a tab facing down there. And we're just going to be pushing that into position on both sides. Hold it at the edge, not the middle. Otherwise, you've got a chance of it breaking, which you don't want to happen. We've got some more windows to put in place now, these small ones. Now, there is a little notch on this. So when you hold this towards you, this would be the left one for me. These are going to go into the little windows at the back here. So that the notch will ensure that when it's in position like this here, that we can still put a screw into the back there. Now, as you can see on the side camera, that will easily fall out. So I am going to put some glue on these just to keep them into place. But when they're in, they should look like that. Show you on the side camera, that's going to leave the windshield now, large windshield here. That's clipped in. So basically, this is going to go in the front. Clips at the bottom, and that sort of holds it in anyway. As you can see, they're not coming out there. But we have got some tabs at the top just to make sure that they're engaged. Mine are. So that's a good sign. Which means I'm now ready to take the grill that we did in stage 3. And that's just going to go into the front here. Again, it's clips. So that will clip in just like that. So that looks like that. So what we're going to do then is we're going to be taking the reflector here, and we've got another lens just to put into the top here. It's a push to fit. Again, that seems quite loose to me, so I'm going to drop a dab of glue in that. So I've got that here. Just put a bit of glue in the inside there. Perfect. Put that into place. And there we go. That's going to hold in no problems. We want to keep this safe. We're not going to be using this straight away. Which means now we're going to be putting the doors on. So I am going to bring up my partwork upgrades, Max. I really don't want to start scratching paintwork now, because this is going to be going upside down. It's going to be going this way around. So the door we're going to put in first looks like this. This is going to go onto this side here. So we bring it in from the outside, and then we're going to be attaching this inner panel to the wall. And there is some clips for that to go in. So we can just line that up and push that into place. You heard some of those clip in there. And then we're going to secure it from this side with a C screw. So I'll put that in here. That's the first door in place. That's going to hold that nice and tight. We just want to check now that the door can open and close. No problems at all. We're going to do the same on the other side. Now, when we're happy with that, we want to take one of the lights that we assembled. We had four left, if you remember. And that's what's going to hide the screws. So I think what I will do is once again, just drop some glue into the holes here so that doesn't come out. And I'll do the same on the other side. Once we've got both of those in, I'm going to turn it this way around. Looking good, isn't it? Let me just show you that. That looks excellent. We're going to be putting the roof on. So this is the roof here. It's going to go around this way. And I think what I'm going to do now is I am going to unwind all of these wires. So we can put this on the top. Just like this. This is one hell of a stage, isn't it? Absolutely loads to do. Okay, line that up. They've got some tabs at the front. So we want to feed those tabs in there. Both sides. There we go. And then make sure that fits nice and flush front. Perfect. So that's on like that. And then we're going to be securing this down with four D screws into these points just here. So I think I'll do the back ones first. That's one, two, three, and four. Now we've got some covers for these screws now. So at the front here, we've got this box here looking like that. That's just going to go over the top of that screw and push that home. We've got one for the other side here, which came in stage five. Let's put that one in as well. Push down. And then in the points of the back, we've got these as well. So we can push these in. One here. And we've got another one here, which again, came in an earlier stage. This one came, I believe, in stage 19. It's going to go in the other side here. That's all in place. Let's turn this upside down. And we're going to be taking these wires. And I want to be running them around the backs here. So one, two, and three. Because I'm going to be putting a headliner down on here now. Now the headliner come in stage 16. And that looks just like this here. What we're going to do is we're going to be putting this in to these points here, making sure that these wires are actually going down on this side here. Now we want them all to come out the back onto this section. So when I put the front in, just like this, I'm going to open these doors up. That's going to help. Push this down and then make sure these wires are coming out from the back. Excellent. And then we can push that into place. These are going to be held in with two type L screws. These screws came in stage 16. They're flange screws. And we're going to have one down the middle here. That's one. And then just one at the back. It will help open the door. Press down really hard. And it should catch the roof of the fire truck. And if I just turn that over, that amazing stage is all there is to do in that stage. That looks brilliant. Once again, when I'm impressed with something, I do want to show you on this camera just to show you how big that looks. That looks brilliant. Look, that's what it looks like inside. The wires now coming out the back. Very, very happy with that. Now in stage 22, we're going to be making another wheel. So the first thing I'm going to do is take the wheel and I'm going to put that into some boiling water there. Just let that soak. I do happen to have that ready. That was handy. Bring up a little cloth here. And all we're going to do is we're going to take this rim and push that around the wheel. Push that wheel out. Perfect. And then just push that into place. All the way around. It's very weird doing it on a small scale like this. Compared to what we're used to, you want to make sure that it's over on each side. I'm just checking here. That looks good. Two more here. And that looks perfect. So there we go. We've got another wheel completed there. And then bringing up the chassis where we already got one wheel in, we're just going to be putting this in the other side here. That's just going to go into this side just like that. It's going to be held in with a type L screw. Now we have one of them over from stage 15, I believe. So I've got that here and I'll put that in. Excellent, that's in place. And then we've got a hubcap which came in this stage. It's going to line the notches here with the spaces we've got at the top and then push that into place. So there we go, that's in like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. So once again, we've got absolutely loads to do in stage 23. We've got a circuit board here, but we've still got a lot of things that we need to attach to the fire truck. So bringing over the inner cab again, we're going to be putting the last seat into position. That's just going to go on this side here. Once again, once that's pushed down, we're going to be holding that in with a size H screw. That's just going to be going into the underside here. And there we go. We've got six seats in there now. Two at the front, two jump seats reversed, and then two at the back. So I'm going to remove the center console now. So to do that, what we're going to do, it's going to take this partition out again, turn it upside down. I'm going to remove these two screws here. So these are size H screws, I believe. Just keep them to one side so they're nice and safe. And that should enable this bottom section, as you can see there, to come off. Let me just, those screws are going to keep themselves in actually. Put that to one side, because this is where the main control board is going to go. So as you can see, we've got a hole in that side there. That's just going to go over that large hole that we've got on this side. So this is actually going to fit in just like that. Now we've got four holes to keep this into space. So we need to screw this in, and they're going to be screwed in once again with type H screws, but only two are going to be put it in. So we've got one at this side here. Excellent. And then just one in the opposite corner down the other side. Just two screws are going to put these in. Then we're going to take this blue connector, which is coming from the front. That's going to go into the blue plug right here. Simples. Okay. While this is like this now, I'm going to be taking the dashboard that we worked on and I'm going to attach this to the vehicle. That's just going to go these clips here into the slot that you can see just behind the computer. So I'm going to clip this into place. And you should hear it click like that. That's fully attached now. Excellent. So turning it upside down, the ribbon lead that we've got here, that's going to go into the black plug next to the one we've just put in. So this is going to go in here. Make sure you put it around the right way. Line your pins up first. Then make sure it's pushed all the way in. There we go. That one's in as well. The next plug next to it, which is red, yellow and black, I hope that I am colorblind, is going to go into the black plug next to that. Again, make sure that's pushed all the way down. Excellent. So I put that to one side. I'm going to bring over the main section that we had here, because I'm going to start to install the cluster lights. These are the cluster lights that we made here. You want to ensure you've got the right way, because if it's on the left side of the vehicle, you want the arrow pointing towards the left. So this is going to go through the front here. And it's going to fit in to this section just like that. Now, it's a push in, and it will hold itself quite well in there. We do the same thing on the right hand side. Again, line it up and then push that in. So I've turned it the right way round, and as you can see, they're in place now. Keeping it turned upside down now, I'm going to start to install the front doors. So this will be the first one. I'm just going to put the door in first. So once the door's actually through, we're going to thread the cable through the hole that we got there. So it comes out there, and then we should be able to push this into the holes, hard to see, that we've got at the front there. So just lining this up. Looking good. Shut the door is probably a best way to actually do this, and then push this in. Now that's going to be held in once again with a type C screw. I've got that here, and I'll screw this into place. Excellent. And then we just do the same on the other side. And then we're just going to cover the screw holes at the front there with those reflectors again. We had two reflectors left. Once again, I am going to use just a little bit of glue around here to keep these in. So when they're in, they look just like that. So much we've done in this stage. So what I'm going to do is just turn this upside down. And now the cables that we've got here, I want to make sure they come out the front here. Because when I put the center console back in, I don't want that getting trapped. I'm going to put on the glass partition again. We had before, make sure that's in space. And I'm going to lower it into place so the tabs on this partition are going into the tabs just there. Gently pushing the back, then the front, slowly to get this all the way down. Ensuring that these cables here as well aren't going to move. And there we go. That is the cab inside. Looking good. Looking good. It's all done. I've got the wire still coming out the front here. This is what it looks like from underneath. Take your time on that. It's hard, but it's rewarding once it's in, as you can see there. And it should sit quite deep in there. So actually the points of the corners of the white section of the dashboard should be in line with the white section of the engine. Now we're going to be connecting all of these wires up. So I'm going to grab the red connector now, and that's going to be plugged into the red socket just down this side. It's quite a tight fit, this one is. There's not much leeway in this lead, but once I've got this in, you'll be able to see how that goes. So that goes on like that. The blue one is going on the other side over here. So I'll get that lined up as well. And that one's in as well. Now, if you have a look at my leads here, I've actually got them coming straight out of the back of those. And I actually put some insulating tape to make sure that they were flat to this section. And that way you'll get the full length of the lead that you can possibly get, because that red lead is extremely tight there. Now we're working on the roof LEDs. You should have one yellow switch, which is a lot longer than the others. That's just going to go into the end here. Just like that, crossed over. And then the other two, the next longest one, is going into the yellow socket just there. I don't know if you can see it on the top camera. Get this one in. And then the last one's going to be plugged into the blue socket that we've got left just on that side there. And then make sure all of those are in place, nice and tight, which they are. So that should look just like that. Pretty hard, because there isn't much give in some of these wires, especially that red one and one of these yellow ones at the back here. Now I'm going to feed through all of the wires here into this section just to tidy it up. But they don't actually want us to put the base on yet. Obviously, this is the base that we took off. Eventually, that's going to be going over the top there, I'm guessing, like this. I will put it on just as a dry fit, because you know what I'm like. I always have to have a fiddle. So I'll get that on there just to have a kind of look at how that's going to go. There you go. See, I can't help myself. I have put the cab inside there just to see how that looks. It sits really well. Obviously, I'm going to have to take that back out again, but what an amazing pack. So much to do. I think the wires are a little bit tricky. And I think the reason for that is because you really do need to route them good. Otherwise, they're not going to hit the points in the circuit board where you want to plug it into. But hopefully, that's probably the hardest stage of the build. And we've got that over and done with in pack three. This video's taken all morning, so it's going to take a lot of editing as well. But I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.